What's going on, everybody? It's Jay Wilson! And I need to show you this. And it's one of those weird things where you don't really get to see stuff like this all of the time. But I think it's something that we need to talk about because there are distributors. There's fish, there's dry goods, there's food, there's the whole thing. And honestly, it's fresh, it's salt, it's plants. And we have to understand that it happens. This is the way it is so that they can come to you. And it's done really cool right here in North Carolina. And we're at Carolina Aquatics. Come on! So with distribution, there are so many different moving parts that we don't see as hobbyists. Well, I get to, but, and maybe some of you do too, but it really is insane, especially on the live fish side. Now, there are so many moving parts, as I said, you've got to have folks that are monitoring these fish, testing the water, making sure they're acclimating properly, holding them, making sure that the water quality stays well, and honestly, understanding how fish are kept. Is it a perfect system? No, it never is. But the cool stuff that you get to see from all over the world, from Indonesia to South America, Central America, I mean, the Pacific, the corals, there is really some awesome stuff. So, I mean, cue the music and let's see some really neat stuff. So as you can see, there are a ton of fish, saltwater, coral, you name it, it's here, and it is simply phenomenal. But that's not just the only part of all of this. When you're employing over 20-something people to run an operation that delivers what we need for our fish store, it takes a lot of other logistical planning. It's routes. It's what route is the best? Is it effective? Do I want to go that far? And the further the reach, maybe the more profitable, but maybe it's not. Maybe you lose some money. Maybe if you bring on the wrong product. So there are so many different finite details that ultimately you have to make as someone who owns and operates a facility like this, let alone what Carolina Aquatics is doing. And one of the neat things that I got to participate in is working with Ceche and being able to arrive into North Carolina, hang out with Chris from Carolina, and drive around to stores all over the place. And going into these stores and finding out what their needs are and what needs aren't met is really eye-opening, especially in, I guess you could say, the world we live in today. But if you're a local fish store or you have a fish store that you absolutely love and it's really running anywhere in the Carolinas to Virginia, parts of Tennessee, I mean, and continually expanding, he carries a ton of stuff. Let's see what time it is. It's almost 10 o'clock and the owner is still here. He's still working since this morning on a Friday and will be with me tomorrow. There's nobody else. sometimes that's what it takes. So I'll leave you with this. If you want to succeed in whatever it is you want to do, you got to grind hard. I'm talking everything you got inside of you has to come out and be put into 100% what you want to achieve. Because if you don't, you're not going to achieve even close to what you imagined. Sometimes you got to make some really big sacrifices, and it's hard. Trust me, it's hard. But in the end, I bet you it's worth it. Thank you so much for watching, liking. Do me a favor, go to Instagram, check out Carolina Aquatics. I believe off the top of my head, it's CA Wholesale, I believe. He said, yep. But everything you need to know is down in the description. And whenever you're in a store in any one of the states I mentioned, you may be looking at fish and dry goods from Carolina Aquatics. Thank you so much. You know what's next. Holla!